Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On November 19th Eastern Time, 2 days after launching aboard a Soyuz spacecraft from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, the Expedition 5051 crew, including NASA astronaut Peggy Whitson, arrived safely at the International Space Station. A few hours after docking, Whitson and Expedition 5051 crewmates Oleg Novitskiy of the Russian space agency Roscosmos and Thomas Pesquet of the European Space Agency were greeted by Space Station Commander Shane Kimbrough of NASA and Sergey Ryzhikov and Andrey Borisenko of Roscosmos. The arriving crew members, who are scheduled to remain on the space station until next spring, will contribute to more than 250 research experiments while onboard the orbital laboratory. Orbital ATK's Cygnus spacecraft left the space station on November 21st, almost a month after the commercial cargo ship arrived at the station with more than 5,100 pounds of supplies and experiments. After ground controllers used the station's Canadarm2 robot arm to detach the Cygnus from the space station, Expedition 50 Commander Shane Kimbrough of NASA and Thomas Pesquet of ESA commanded the robotic arm to release Cygnus as both spacecraft flew over the Pacific Ocean near the west coast of Colombia. The Cygnus will be used for a fire safety experiment and the launch of several CubeSats before it deorbits and safely burns up over the Pacific Ocean on November 27th.
And liftoff of NOAA's GOES arm.
On November 19th, NASA successfully launched the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's GOES-R satellite. GOES-R, the first in a series of highly advanced NOAA geostationary weather satellites, launched aboard a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida. When GOES-R reaches its final designated orbit, it will be renamed GOES-16. Following a checkout and validation period for its six new instruments, the satellite will become operational within a year. Data from GOES-R will result in 34 new or improved meteorological, solar, and space weather products, and will increase the nation's weather observation capabilities, leading to more accurate and timely forecasts, watches, and warnings. Engineers at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, recently moved a test version of the interim cryogenic propulsion stage for the agency's Space Launch System rocket to a test stand designed to subject SLS hardware to forces similar to those experienced in flight. Testing is scheduled to begin in 2017 after the rest of the rocket's test articles are stacked in the stand. The ICPS is the propulsion stage that will give NASA's Orion spacecraft the in-space push needed to fly beyond the moon before it returns to Earth on the first flight of SLS and Orion in 2018. NASA's Ground Systems Development and Operations Program continues making progress on upgrades and modifications to the Vehicle Assembly Building at the agency's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The second half of the C-level work platforms was installed recently inside the VAB. Level C is the eighth of 10 platform levels that, when complete, will provide access to NASA's Space Launch System rocket and Orion spacecraft for testing and processing before future deep space missions.
This is our cornbread dressing that we will obviously put some water in and heat it up.
In a downlink message recorded November 18th on board the International Space Station, Expedition 50 Commander Shane Kimbrough of NASA talked about the crew's plans to celebrate the Thanksgiving holiday. A few days later, during a Facebook Live from the Astronaut Food Lab at Johnson Space Center in Houston, the food scientist staff conducted a combined show-and-tell taste test with some of the items on the crew's Turkey Day menu, including green beans and mushrooms, smoked turkey, and, of course, cornbread dressing. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twarm.